Welcome to the noise party. This camera's giving me some problems here. I'm just barely getting enough light, as you can see. But I think you caught the tip end of the noise party logo. That would be enough to render this an acceptable logo for the purposes of the highly sophisticated broadcasting apparatus, which CCTV employs. Anyway, this is Noise Party, and we'd like to present at this time the Cabaret of the Oddly Normal, live at AS220 at 115 Empire Street in Providence, Rhode Island. Thank you.
Welcome to the Cabaret of the Oddly Normal. Tonight's featured guests are the Zen Psychotic, The Wrong Hero, Greg Gemma, Just Victor, Tom Hurdle, and Algernon. And now, Princess Pearl and the Cabaret Band, featuring Steve Dubois, Pete DeChico, and Stella.
Thank you. like, Parallette, you can leave the stage now and take a bow. In the past with remembering things, like lyrics to songs. So I'm like, all right, I'm not gonna bring the words with me. And we went to do all the cute little dance steps, and what happens? I sing entirely out of key. I'm so sorry. Darn it, sorry guys. Next up, Steve, Sean, what do we have? Scott.
I love President Clinton. I love him. I love President Clinton. I love him. I love him for all the things he promised to do and didn't do. I love President Clinton. I love him. I love him for bombing Iraq once again because it's election time and it looks good. I love that kind of thinking, and I'll tell you why shortly, but I love him. I love our illustrious congressmen. I love their bank accounts when they get contributions from tobacco lobbies for cigarettes that are killing me. I love congressmen. I love the welfare reforms. I love it. You know why I love it? I really, 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 really love it. I love it. I love the shit out of it. I love what they're doing to the rest of the world. I love them. I love them so much. I have so much love from the bottom of my heart. I love the busy intellectuals who know exactly how the system works. But they don't do anything about it because they're happy where they are. They don't want to be down here with us. And then there are people worse off than us. I love. You think you've got it bad? Live in the third world. We complain? Do we complain? Live in the third world, where they cut the faces off of women and hang them upside down. Sponsored by the CIA. I love them all. And the reason I love them all is because the more they do, the worse it gets. The closer I'm going to be, and you, liberation. This is the dawning of the age of Aquarius, the age of Aquarius, Aquarius, harmony and understanding, la da 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 da.
The steering wheel is like this.
You see that? It's like this. It's not like this. All right? It's like this. And when you're driving hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of miles, you want your arms out straight, okay? That's it. That's the thing about 18-wheelers. That's one of the things. There are many things about 18-wheelers, and you bet your little asses I'm going to tell you all the things I can think of about 18-wheelers while I'm up here in my 18-wheeler. I love it, okay? Point number two. I don't have to start it because I never shut it off. It's diesel. It's always running. You ever see diesels? They're always running. My 18-wheeler is always running. Even when I'm on weekends off, I keep it running. Point three. My 18-wheeler and all 18-wheelers, most of them, I guess, have a lot of gears. And they sit high up. I have to wear boots because when I gotta punch that clutch in, I gotta punch that clutch in. I'm gonna go through some of the gears for you now. Ready? First gear. Second gear. Third gear. Fourth gear. Fifth gear.
Kaboom!
You gotta keep up your maintenance on an 18-wheeler, I tell you. You don't fuck around. Safety comes first. Safety is always first. 15th gear. And now I'm up to 10 glorious miles an hour. And I got 15 or 16 more gears to go. You know it. When I'm on the highway, cruising along hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of miles, and I see those little Hondas coming up beside me. You know what I like to do? You know what I like to do? I like to wave them on. Come on, go ahead. And then they get in front of me. And I kind of creep up on their bumper. And I let them know about the loudest vehicle horn there ever is. Flash those high beams on them. And they get out of the way. And I'm cruising down the highway. But it's lonely up here on the highway, doing hours and hours and hours and hours in my 18-wheeler. Hours and hours. So what do? You don't have any guesses, do you? I get on my CB set. And I talk to other 18-wheelers out there. The thing with a CB set is you gotta have a name. We call it a handle. My handle is T-Rex. Breaker, breaker. Breaker. Anybody out there? This is T-Rex. I'm looking for somebody out there. Is there anybody out there? Come back. Yeah, breaker. One more. This is Big Dan. Is that you, T-Rex? Is that you out there? Hey, Big Dan. Nice to hear from you again. What's happening out there? How's the road down the line? I got a load of fresh fish in my refrigeration unit broke down in Boston. Can you tell me about any Smokies out there, Big Dan? Yeah, T-Rex, here's a scoop on that. You go down to the Route 44 down there, you're going to take a 95, and then you're going to take a 95, and then you're going to take a 95. Yeah, you got that. Big Dan, that was the greatest litany
of amphetamine-related bullshit I've ever heard in the last 3 days. Thanks a lot. Keep popping those overdreams down. Okay.
A friend of mine is going to be moving out to California. Actually, a couple of friends of mine. We got the big Just Victor. He's moving out there with his wife, Joan. Possibly Joe Auger. He's going to be going out there. And seeing as I got this goddamn big 18-wheeler, the biggest motherfucker on the road, I think I can give him a lift. So, let's just get in the back. Come on, Scotty, get it back there. Joe, Joan. Hey, Joan, I know you got a lot of Winnie the Pooh paraphernalia. Let's take up half the truck. Watch out for those smelly fish, though. You know that refrigeration unit is kind of broken down. Come on, pile it all in there and do it while I'm running, because I can't stop. I've been doing amphetamine too. Okay. I love this amphetamine because I gotta stay awake on the highway. You understand what I'm saying? Then we're driving down the highway. I got all my friends in the back of the truck, and I'm supposed to be going to New York, but I'm gonna turn around, and I'm gonna take them to California anyway. Fuck, those fish went bad anyway. We're headed to California now. To hell with it. That's the way it goes. I'm an independent truck driver. I don't have to worry about answering any goddamn company. Wish I could get a hat that would stay on. Cruising down the highway. Hey, Scott, feel free to make some calamari if you find any in there, will you? Attention, you down there in the truck. This is F Eagle 1, United States Air Force. You are in the no-fly zone. What? Scotty, better hurry up with that calamari. Eagle 1, this is Eagle 7. The truck doesn't seem to be paying any attention to us down. I'm going to go down and take a closer look. He is in the no-fly zone. Yes, Eagle 7, I went down and counted them. It is an 18-wheeler. Count them, 1, 2, through 18. But it smells like rotten fish. I think we ought to waste his ass. Okay, locked on heat-seeking missiles on the 18-wheeler with the smelly fish and the Italian in the back making calamari. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, each year, hundreds of American soldiers are killed by friendly fire. If you're fed up with friendly fire and all of the other wonderful atrocities committed by our wonderful government who are supposed to be responsible for us, please write, "We don't think friendly fire is so friendly. Care of the White House, Pennsylvania Avenue, Washington, D.C. Thank you very much.
interesting. This is an ad I saw. Young female seeks male companionship. I love long walks in the woods, riding in your pickup truck, hunting, camping, and fishing trips. Cozy winter nights spent lying by the fire. Candlelight dinners will have me eating out of your hand. Rub me the right way, and I will respond to your tender caresses. I'll be at the front door when you get home from work. Kiss me and I'm yours. I'm a svelte, good-looking girl who loves to play. Call 946-1213 and ask for Daisy. I am an 8-week-old white Labrador retriever. $150.
Toothpaste out of my mouth. Hi, I'm the wrong hero. I'm so tender and juicy, you might be tempted to eat me with a fork, but don't, because you won't want to miss one drop of the goodness. Any hard drugs? Kids, you don't need drugs. Give them to me. I can use them. Actually, I'm addicted to placebos. I'm trying to cut down, though. Now I'm doing placebo light. Only half the inert ingredients and fillers of regular placebos. Also addicted to spam, but again, trying to cut down. Doing spam light. Only half the hog eyelids and salivary glands of regular spam. On a diet, it's called the beer for breakfast diet. Brain fat just melts away like magic. Also doing the X-lax diet. Shed ugly brown pounds in seconds. Oh, and by the way, this episode of The Wrong Hero is brought to you by Elvis Wine. It's the wine that Elvis would have drank if Elvis drank wine. And also by new Elvis Crack. It's the crack Elvis would have smoked if crack had been invented. Thinking of doing a TV show, sort of like the Dukes of Hazzard, but based around the premise that Jesus was the first bootlegger because he changed the water into wine. It's like, we got spent revenues, Jesus! Holy cow, he's changing white water rafting into white wine rafting! Let's get our arts folks now! Here comes Boss Pilot, look out! Might sell, I don't know. Man with the loud laugh, I like you. Well, you know, a lot of comedy is based around anger, but unfortunately I'm angry because there's nothing to protest anymore, really. I mean, you know, you had nuclear bombs and Vietnam and apartheid and Reagan, but all that seems to be but a distant memory. And I guess the one thing that people my age are concerned about is being overweight, but somehow marching on Washington going, no more mayonnaise! Down with eggs! Down with eggs! Somehow it just doesn't have quite the same panache. Baby Watson! Out of my mouth! Now! I was watching that Beatles documentary, to coincide with the release of the third Beatles anthology and the 10-hour Ted Turner video Beatles anthology. As if 4.5 hours weren't enough, 4.5 hours of outtakes and George sort of sitting there mumbling, I don't know, why don't you ask Ringo? Yeah, I think he did write it for the occasion. Oh, no, he didn't write it. They didn't once mention perhaps the best and most inventive Beatles song of all. Not Revolution 9, but Tomorrow Never Knows. Well, I got to listening to that, and,
Turn on to my relaxing float downstream.
Sounds like Don Adams from Get Smart, you know, in Tennessee, Texas.
It is not dying. Say, Chumley, it is not dying. Sorry about that, Chief. Turn off your mind, relax.
That would have been a great thing to have at the Democratic and Republican and Reform Party conventions, or, you know, or a wedding or something, you know. Do you take this man?
Turn off!
Yeah, I was thinking, that would be a good theme, though. Tomorrow never knows, because when the conventions were running, you never knew really quite what was going to happen, except, of course, they were all scripted down to the minute. Jack Kemp has athlete's foot in mouth from 8:02 to 8:04. And they had a pretty plan. Bob Dole, you know, he gave a great speech. Like, we must build a bridge to the pet, but he kept on thinking that maybe he would break down and do his Frankenstein number, you know, like,
our lights bright, Bob Dole hates bright light.
You know, everybody's been ribbing on him because he's elderly. In China, that would be an asset, you know. 73? Oh, he's a youngster next to Deng. Come on. But, he's so old, you know. The food in his cupboard, the sell-by dates are in Egyptian hieroglyphics. And, his chicken noodle soup has a Cro-Magnon on the can.
Soup, good!
You know.
I don't like soup.
There was lots of diversity at the GOP convention this year. Let's see, there were the fundamentalists who were gun nuts. There were the fundamentalists who were more into stockpiling freeze-dried food and living in cabins without running water or electric lights. And there were the fundamentalists who suspected that Jesus was soft on communism. And you can tell because you can steal the American cars in the parking lot with the bumper stickers like, caution, Messiah on board, or I break for compound fires, or David Koresh is my co-pilot, or caution, in case of rapture, the driver will vanish. Yeah, that'd be cool. Why doesn't the guy get cruise control, for Christ's sake, in Nevada? He could drive 120 miles, nothing would happen. The Democratic Convention. They asked, the New York Times asked Jesse Jackson why he wasn't asked to speak in primetime. Now, he didn't get all defensive and say, well, you know, just an example of how we've been brutalized. No, he didn't do a Malcolm X. Now, he said, anytime I speak is prime time. And it's like, well, yeah, anytime you speak is also rhyme time, Jesse. You know what I'm saying? It's like, he's a great orator, and they were wise to showcase his immense talents in this field. But, and I'm glad he kept it under control at the Democratic Convention, or else it might have been something like,
be like the nun who has hope in her soul, and not like the prostitute who has soap in, never mind. Be not like the sharpshooter who is nearsighted and shoots and shoots and never hits, and be not like the constipated owl who shoots and hoots and never mind.
You know, if Jesse ever were elected president, I do believe he'd be the first president to give his State of the Union address in iambic pentameter, you know? It's just wonderful. But you know who wasn't at the Democratic Convention? Conspicuous by his absence was Jimmy Carter.
I'm the Jimmy. It's like, I can see how this scenario played out. Bill gets on the phone midnight, the night before the convention. Hello, is Jimmy Carter there? This is Jimmy. How would you like to come to the Democratic convention? Well, it's kind of late notice, Bill. I don't know, maybe I'll just sit this one out. Okay, bye now. At 12:01, Bill's phone rings. He picks it up. Hello, Bill. This is Jimmy. You know, I've had a minute to think about it, and maybe I will show up. I'm out of here. I'm out of here. I can't do it. I'm out of here. This is me. Why not? You know, it's like, out of here. Maybe Bill's problem is, like most people over 35, he has attention deficit disorder. Mostly because when you're over 35, there's really nothing worth paying attention to anyway. But it's like, you know, he goes from one thing to another. Well, we must work on community development. No, we must work on gun control. No, I must lie about my golf game. No, we must work on welfare. No flex time. No reinventing government. No. You know, I just can't wait for the day when he's up there going, I promise to give every American access to... He rips his mask off at Sugar Bear. And I was like, come on, Trent Lott. How's about some of that help here? Yes, I'm just waiting for the day. Ross Perot. Has he picked the vice president yet? I think that you got that gorilla who saved the baby at the zoo. Oh, you know, more humane, more intelligent, bigger ears, makes Ross look good. You know? Love to see that. And his reform convention speech, I don't think anybody watched it, but I can imagine what transpired there.
Well, as my friend Henry Truman used to say, if you can't stand the heat, get away from the sun. That was before he was abducted by aliens and started fighting. But you know, in politics, I'm like the turd in the punch bowl. I'm like the bastard at the family reunion. Well, politics is not a slapping contest between tranny waste and the bathtub overflows, and you don't smoke a man down with the bathwater. You look at Bocco, he's stinky and mean, and his name sounds like a British pension plan. And oh, never mind, I was flying over Area 54 in Roswell, New Mexico, and I was thinking to myself, if I'm elected president, I will never let aliens blow up the White House. I'll do it myself. That Ralph Nader, he's running with the Green Party. I think he's been driving in too many cars without an airbag. That's just my opinion. And I was thinking, I'm here, you're there, I'm here, you're there, they're there, and God bless America, and Perot we trust. I have a question, incidentally. What happens when you pour ginger ale onto Rice Krispies? I don't know. I have another impression. Keep moving. Half John Wayne, half Doris Day, man. If you touch that gun, I'll kill you. Oh! Why do people pray to God? I think it's for much the same reason that dogs howl when you turn the garbage disposal on. So I'd like to do an impression. It's a dog howling at a garbage disposal with a police siren in the background and a spitting cat. That one needs work. Sometimes I feel like I'm in a silent movie that has some of the frames missing, you know? Well, I may fail, but I'm original.
accept your applause.
Where's the fucking standing ovation?
No, that's Pearl's. That's Pearl's prerogative. I mustn't. As I was saying, I may fail, but I'll fail better. Samuel Beckett said that, but he hasn't been gigging lately, so. Well, I feel so good, I think I'll do something that I'm not even prepared to do, and you probably won't really like very much, but I really don't care. I mean, I do care, but I don't, but I kind of do. It's called The Hate Boat.
Hate. It is in everything that you do. It's hate. It makes me want to crush you with my shoe. The Hate Boat. It's hate. It's hate.
I'm the wrong hero. Thank you very much.
Thank you. are the NBS, the No Bullshit Party. Now what I'm going to explain to you right now, a lot of you are going to like one bit. Do we've got any Democrats here tonight voting for Clinton? Oh come on, we must have some. Right, that's it, the poor bastard. How about Dole? Anyone here vote for Dole? Oh, it's too friendly a crowd, is it? We'll see when you go to the vote booth, though.
None of the above!
Right, none of the above. That'll get you nowhere.
What about Ross Perot?
Ross Perot? Fucking bastard. But I'll tell you what, at least with Ross Perot, it'll make a difference. Because if you vote for the Democrat and a Republican and a Republican and a Democrat and a Republican, whatever the fuck they call themselves, your vote is irrelevant. And do you know why? Does anyone know why?
Why?
You don't know why?
Because they're both the same.
Because.
Why?
Why? Oh, you're making fun of me, are you? Oh, is that it? I'll go ahead and kick your ass. Maybe a bit later. Well, the reason is this. Because who do you think actually controls this country?
Aliens.
Aliens, is it? Right. Well, Elvis actually has more control than either Clinton or Dole. I mean, he's practically a demigod in this society, isn't he? So how fucking far you've gone down. See, the thing is this, is that they are control. I mean, the only ones that they let run are the type of people they can control. And who are they, you might ask?
Who are they?
Coca-Cola, Marlboro cigarettes, Exxon, and Disney. That's who they are. And they're the same bastards who's controlled everything forever. They gave you the Vietnam War, right? They gave you organized slavery, as well as the Crusades. It's the same people. So therefore, your vote is irrelevant. Now my platform is simply this. No fucking bullshit. That's it. Rational fucking thinking. No bullshit. And rather than sit up here and tell you what my platform is, I'm going to define it for you through your questions. Now you can't think, can't you? It's TV completely taken that away from you. Can any of you think?
Yeah.
Right, well you got a question then.
Yeah.
All right.
Anything about legalizing marijuana?
Of course.
All right.
Well you can't step it out, can you? Right? Yeah. I mean, everyone's got a voice. Everyone in here's got a voice. Most of you here have got 7 or 8. And you've all got a voice, and if you legalize it, it just keeps, I mean, you can't stop it, right? But we all know this. What else?
National language.
National language? You can't even speak fucking English. And you want a national language. You know, maybe the founding fathers of this country had a bright idea when they didn't make one. Do you ever think of that? Because at the time, see, now of course, you're American, so you don't know your own history. But at the time, there were 13 colonies, and 5 of them, the majority of people didn't speak English. How's about that? Right, so next one. Where are we going from here?
Nigel.
Yeah, right.
If you don't make it, what's our next resort?
Organized revolution. What do you think of that?
Who's going to organize it?
You are. What do you think is going to organise it? You're going to sit your fucking asses in your living rooms watching TV and someone else is going to organise it?
How about Dick Morris?
He's good at that.
Dick Morris? Jesus Christ, I heard he's good at getting his dicks, you know, sucked. That's a different thing. That's a prerequisite, isn't it?
Who's your running mate?
My running mate? I've not got one. How about you? You want to come up? You can be my running mate. Anyone else? You want to be my running mate?
Where are we running?
I've got an heroin habit. I mean, it makes it fun. It means you might get to be president. Right. Well, short of a revolution, I think the first thing that we need to do is kill certain people.
Yeah.
I mean, I agree with it. I've got to take a drink now. Excuse me. I'm an alcoholic as well. Right, and the next thing, I've got a fag as well. That means something different here, I know.
Who are we going to kill, Nigel?
Who am I going to kill? Well, the first one is the bleeding advertisers. You know what I mean? The marketing executives. Was it Madison Avenue here in New York? That's the place, right?
Yeah.
Are you watching these things?
Coke is
you've seen a bleeding Infinity or Lexus or whatever the fuck commercial it is? It's a stupid twit standing on a bridge in Paris, right? And it cars riding by and he's like, why do you get up so early? Why do you stay so late? Why do you play the game? Is it worth it? So what? So you can buy his $50,000 piece of shit? I guess it is then, sure. Kill me. Make me not spend time with my family and the people I love. I'll just stay at work so I can buy your fucking shit. Bollocks. You know, it's a nice thing to do sometimes.
Waste them.
You ever watch advertisements with the sound turned off? Do it sometime. I've seen this one. It's a breakfast cereal commercial, right? And they got this partly, and you know, she's got a nice bum wearing a negligee, prancing around. As if, I don't know, as if I eat Rice Krispies, she's gonna give me a blowjob. I don't know what that means. It's all very strange, though. Then we need to kill. I don't know who else, but perhaps you've got some suggestions.
What about them people that put them sun-ripened stickers on them green tomatoes?
Yeah.
Who are they? And who are they?
Farmers! Kill farmers!
No, we can't kill farmers. Now, that brings up another interesting thing, though.
Well,
illegal aliens, right? Everyone in Scotland is talking about illegal aliens. They're taking away from us. They're invading our school systems. They're using our welfare. Here's another bit of information for you. 9% of all American citizens at some time or another will be on welfare. Do you know what the percentage is of aliens, legal or illegal? Any idea? 7%. Fuck off! Another thing about illegal aliens. Fine, you don't want them here, get rid of them. And then you know what's going to happen? You're going to pay $5 for a fucking orange. You ever been to California or Texas? You ever been there, mate? No. Well, see, when you go there, there's nothing but fucking illegal aliens working in everything. They're the one who pick your oranges and every fucking other thing you eat. So you don't want them? Fine. Pay $5 fucking dollars for an orange. That's fine. Next question. My convention, this is it, right here.
Yeah. When do the balloons come down?
Oh. We've not got any balloons.
Here's one.
Hey. Yeah, but I've got a brick and I'm going to share it with you later. Right, what are you doing? Oh, a balloon. Where is yours?
Hey, you lied.
Well, I didn't know.
You said you were no balloon.
Fuck off.
Well, fuck you too.
Oh, here. We're from Liverpool. Fuck them, I hate them anyways. Liverpool, Manchester, the whole lot. Next question.
Nigel.
Yeah, right.
Do you think they've got an antidote for AIDS and they've been hiding it because they created it because they have an overpopulation and they want to skim us down?
Oh, you took too many drugs in the 60s, didn't you? Don't you realize that we're just fucking bugs? That's all, we're bugs that can read. Every so few fucking years, right, we get a disease that wipes a bunch of us out. Do you remember influenza? That was this century, killed one out of five people. For Christ's sake, we get it, right? Moles get it, birch trees get it. If we didn't have that, we'd be so many fucking men. was actually United States, but it's not. I've explained this to you. It's Exxon. What do you think we thought it was? What do you think we went to Somalia for? What do you think that was about? Saving poor, starving Africans? Oh, yeah, right. Do you know how many fucking poor, starving Africans there's been since the beginning of time? Oh, yeah, that was a humanitarian aid mission. Oh, sure. Look, the poor black babies. I don't think that had a fucking thing to do with it. Do you know that Texaco got the rights to untap oil in Somalia? That's what we do. We're not even a government, for Christ's sake. We're not even a government. All we're doing is going around the world fucking blowing up people for companies. And they don't give a fuck whether you're American or not. They just want your money. Right, so all of a sudden cigarettes will be difficult to buy in the United States. At the same time, they're giving away for 5 cents a pack in third world countries. Get them hooked. As long as they're buying them, they don't give a fuck. And if they stop buying Marlboros, we'll send troops over. Buy the fucking Marlboros in the name of the United States of America. Jesus Christ. Next question.
What do you think about the new Iraqi attacks and all that?
The Iraqi attacks, it's a nice bit of a game, isn't it? Nice circus for us. Blow up a few Muslims, they're the big bad boys now. Yeah, that's right. Blow them up. Next thing you know, we'll have them over here driving the taxis. That's all it is. It's just a fucking game. It's a fucking game, so you don't have to think about it, right? I mean, if you actually had to think about what was going on, but now we don't. Now we can blow a few of them up, and they'll blow, I don't know. They'll kill two of us, and we'll kill another 100,000 of them. It'll be fine. Don't worry about it. Next question.
What will you do as president?
What will I do? Well, I have a lot of money. Right now I'm unemployed, right?
Right.
I figure you get a lot of dates when you're the president of the United States. That'd be nice. I haven't had a bit in a while. There's that. And then there's maybe, I suppose I can get my heroin directly from the CIA now, rather than having to go through people. There's that, and then, I don't really know. I mean, there's a few places I'd like to blow up if I can get in there. You know?
Where?
Oh, Jesus.
Jersey?
Oh, no, nothing here.
Montana?
Oh, no, they've got enough people blowing themselves up.
Three gorges down.
What'd you say?
Three gorges down in China.
No, I like the Chinese. I like them. There's some people I don't like, but I can't remember who they are.
Wall Street.
Wall Street. Oh, they blow themselves up. I mean, lawyers. We need them.
Lawyers.
Liars? No, they're just fucking tools. In many ways, you know what I mean? They're just fucking tools. Blow up. No, just individuals, you know. I'd like to go back and get Maggie Thatcher. You know, maybe her. And maybe fucking Oasis. I'm tired of them. I'm tired of the Beatles as it is. We don't need another one. Right. Next question. Are you all questioned that? I mean, this is the future of your fucking country here.
What about the militia movement?
The militia movement. Like them. I like them a lot. You ever read the Unabomber's Manifesto?
Yes.
Isn't it great? Everything in the world. I mean, if he blew up the right fucking people, maybe somebody would listen. I mean, he's a genius. Now, here's another one. That is one thing I would do away with. My first day, I'd shut the electricity the fuck off. You know what I'm saying? Get rid of the computer. You know why? Because this, I actually heard this. They're going to try and sell you it this way. Talking about invasion of privacy, right? At this stage in the game, a lot of places, they don't even take cash. You can't go into a hotel room and, you know, just go about your business and pay them cash. They want a credit card. They're telling people, oh, you can use a credit card for your gas, you can use a credit card for your groceries and so forth, right? All that is just control. They know exactly what you're buying. And a computer, this is what they're gonna sell it to you with. I actually seen this. The computer is going to free mankind from dishonesty. Do you like that? Yeah.
Oh.
That's what they said. This very wise gentleman was 30 years old or something. That's what he says. Yes, because of the invasion of privacy, what he's going to do is make the world a safer and more honest society. What a load of bullshit. So that's the first thing they do. Shut off the electricity and go on your own. Welfare. Now there's one. Now they're gonna take welfare away. But they're not going to, because they're not that stupid. Thank God for welfare. I'm gonna tell you why. Poverty in this country, unless you're homeless, is fairly nice. Poverty's still got a TV, still got some form of transportation, be it a shit box or a bus pass, and it's still got, you know, a few of the comforts of life, right? You take it away, and then you see what happens. Then it'll be slitting your throat like they are in Brazil. You like that? They're not gonna take it away. Don't worry about that. Any more questions?
Who killed JFK?
Wait, yes.
Box of debris.
Nothing at all.
Who killed JFK?
JFK? I don't know.
Kill himself.
Oh, he didn't kill himself, you should. What difference is it, mate? What's this thing with JFK? I mean, it doesn't fucking matter, does it? He's fucking dead. He was nothing but a tool. And now you guys have been worrying about this fucking tool for the past, what has it been, 30 years? 32 years, right? Stupid. Anything else?
What about the deficit?
Gun control. That's one of the reasons I moved to this country, because I can have a gun. The more guns, the better, as far as I'm concerned, because it's the only way we can have a revolution. Right?
What about the deficit and all that?
The deficit. Here we go. Stop building bombs one fucking day and we take care of the deficit. There you go.
What about the space program?
Fuck it, there's nothing out there.
What about the Sex Pistols?
The Sex Pistols, great! Couldn't play a fucking note though, could they?
Words.
sorry about that. A little off tune. Now we at least knew the words, kind of.
It was great. But,
I'd like to introduce Tom Hurdle. Please put your hands together.
Thank you.
This is an old story. I didn't want to tell it to that group because Tom heard the story. But it's an old story. A man walks into a bar. He's had a miserable fucking day. He wants to tell the bartender his troubles. Have to drink whiskey. The bartender is an ostrich, unhappy with the American way of life. As soon as the guy started to talk, the bartender just steps him up and says, look, asshole. Why don't you tell this to somebody who gives a shit? So tell it to the urine, they'll give a shit before I will. So the man in need of sympathy and a piss goes to the bathroom. The bathroom just reeks. Stinks. All kinds of... I got nerves. Just reeks. Yeah, it's got shit all over the floor, all the stink. It smells like chicken coop. And he goes up to the urinal and starts to unzip his fly, and he sees shit moving in the urinal. Oh, God, silverfish or something. Fuck. Hates bugs. And then, geez, it doesn't quite look right. So he takes a closer look, and there is movement, things in it, but it's not bugs. He takes a real close look, and it's, then there's a little stage. Like on the bottom of the urinal is a little stage, and on top of the stage performing, it's a, holy shit, it's a quarter inch high Elvis Presley. The guy can't believe it. And Christ, he's backed up by the Jordanaires, for Christ's sake. And then he looks, and the whole side of the urinal is encrusted with an audience just stomping their feet, clapping and cheering, going crazy. And wow, what a fucking deal. He reaches down, he grabs Elvis and puts him in his pocket. Fucking audience goes nuts. The guy flushes the toilet and down they go. Then he goes, I can't show this to the bartender. Man, slaps the man, Elvis on the right. Look at this, what the? I found this in the toilet. Bartender, the ostrich, slaps a shot glass right over the Elvis. Screams the man, you son of a bitch, that's the house Elvis. And then the guy, what are you talking about? And here's behind you, other people. Wow, you got the house Elvis up. Boom. What that no-neck, that short-neck bastard doing? The guy looks around, holy shit, he's in a bar full of ostriches. And they're all fucking mad at him, man. And with their big, long necks moving, and they're coming closer to him, and they're chanting at him, automobile driver, automobile driver. And they're cursing at him, like, and making fun of his little short neck and his little bony arm. They're just laughing at him, but it's not funny. They're laughing, but they're getting ready to stomp him, and they just pull him out. Stomp the shit out of him with their big feet, clawing him out all kinds of little pieces and throw him out the door. He's laying out in the gutter. Cop walks up to him and says, that'll teach you, this son of a bitch. Never go into an ostrich bar.
Ready? Go!
Throw it!
Throw it!
Throw it!
Throw it!
Throw it!
Throw it!
Throw it! Throw it!
about fertility rituals.
Thank you. The Robert Jazz Film Festival with their new name, The Majestic. So, if those of you who want to come and check out a film, and I think it's a Dean Martin film actually, come by at around, yes, come by at 7 o'clock, watch Alan Steve do a recording session. Basically, this is what we're doing, is at 7 o'clock, they're going to be doing a set on stage. We're going to be recording it for a possible CD. It's a recording session. We need to have you come down and make noise. 8 o'clock, there'll be films and Be Majestic, formerly the Robert Jazz Quartet.
Thank you.
been the Cabaret of the Oddly Normal, recorded live at AS220, and featuring the usual suspects. Hosted by Princess Pearl of Providence, emceed by Scott Shern, and featuring the Zen Psychotic, a.k.a. Mini Pombo, the Wrong Hero, a.k.a. Francis DiMenno, your producer. Let's see, who else was there? Greg Gemma, Just Victor, a.k.a. Scott Canzano, Tom Hurdle, and closing the evening's festivities, Algernon. You may be wondering why we devoted the last 25 minutes of this to a shot of the audience. It's because the show ran short. And of course, we're on a very tight schedule, even though you are viewing a program which was actually shot sometime in September. And of course, it is now the end of January. Nevertheless, we hope to be bringing you more of the Cabaret of the Oddly Normal in the weeks to come. Of course, we're shooting one show a month here, and this is a weekly show, so sooner or later we're going to run out of footage. When that day finally arrives, I'm sure we'll think of something. Until then, this is Francis DiMenno, producer of Noise Party. Glad you could show up. Party is broadcast every Wednesday night on Cambridge Community Television, Channel 55 at 9 p.m. and will be broadcast every Wednesday night for the foreseeable future, regardless of whether we have any new footage or not. Also, tune into our companion show, Cafe Cabaret, featuring The Wrong Hero. That's right, 2 hours of hero madness every Tuesday night on Cambridge Community Television, Channel 55 at 9 p.m.